Hello students, I'm going to discuss the quick solutions of All India Akash Test Series Medical 2021 TYM. Your test is test number 6, code C and D. Your test was held on 1st of March 2020. I'll be dealing with the botany section. So the very first question in the botany section is question number 91. Which of the following statements with respect to glycolysis are true? A. Glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm of the cell. It is true that glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell, as it is the breakdown of glucose. B. Glycolysis involves single step reaction that breaks down glucose into pyruvic acid. No doubt, glycolysis is conversion of glucose into pyruvic acid, but it is not a single step reaction. It involves 10 steps. So glycolysis is a 10 steps reaction. So this is wrong. C. Glycolysis is a part of aerobic respiration, so it requires oxygen. No, glycolysis does not require oxygen, as it is common in both aerobic and anaerobic organisms. This is the common pathway which occurs in both type of organisms. It does not require oxygen at all. D. Glycolysis is an energy producing process and does not consume energy at any step. This is wrong. Without doubt, it is energy producing process, but it consumes energy in the initial steps. Now, only A is correct. So the correct option for the given question is option number 4. Let's see the next question. Question number 92. The first step of EMP pathway, glycolysis is also known as EMP pathway. So the first step of EMP pathway in obligate aerobic organisms involves: first option, phosphorylation of glucose in the presence of oxygen with the help of an enzyme isomerase. Here you can see I have shown you the first step of the EMP pathway. This is the glycolysis or EMP pathway, and here you can see this first step in which glucose is being converted into glucose 6-phosphate. So here phosphorylation of glucose occurs, but not in presence of oxygen, because glycolysis does not require oxygen, as I discussed in the previous question. And here the enzyme is not isomerase, it is the hexokinase. So this is wrong. Second, no use of ATP molecule as energy source. No, here you can see there's use of ATP molecule. So this is also wrong statement. Third one, formation of glucose 6-phosphate in presence of O2 only. No, glycolysis does not require oxygen. So this is incorrect. Fourth one, phosphorylation of glucose using ATP. Yes, phosphorylation of glucose using ATP. ATP is being used and there is phosphorylation of glucose, and hence glucose 6-phosphate is formed in the presence of enzyme hexokinase. Yes, and no oxygen is required. Yes, so this is the first step of glycolysis. So the correct option for the given question is option number 4. Let's move to the next question. Question number 93. Substrate level phosphorylation is phosphorylation of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. No, it is not the substrate level phosphorylation. Phosphorylation is ATP production, and substrate level phosphorylation is direct ATP production. In any of the metabolic reaction, if you see, there is formation of ATP. This is called the substrate level phosphorylation. But if there is production of NADH2, FADH2 or NADPH2, then finally they will give you ATP, but this is not the substrate level phosphorylation, as it is indirect formation of the ATP. So the first statement is wrong. Second one, direct synthesis of ATP from metabolites. Yes, it is true. Synthesis of NADH by reducing NAD+. This is indirect method. Fourth, interconversion of triose sugars. No. So the correct option for the given question is option number 2. Let's move to the next question. Question number 94. Oxidation of one molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate in a living cell through glycolysis leads to synthesis of First option, one molecule of pyruvic acid, two molecules of ATP and one molecule of NADH2. So before solving this question, you can see here, this is the glycolysis or the glycolytic pathway in which 10 steps are given. And here you have to focus from glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate, then fructose 6-phosphate, and then fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is formed. Now, this fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now, after formation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, what is the outcome? Here, the end product of glycolysis is pyruvic acid. So, one molecule of glucose gives you two molecules of pyruvic acid. But one molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will give you one molecule of pyruvic acid. So, option number 2 is ruled out, where two molecules of pyruvic acid is written. Only one molecule of pyruvic acid will be obtained. Now, here you can see two molecules of ATP are formed. This is ATP and this is also ATP. So, two molecules of ATP. Hence, option number 3 is ruled out, because here one molecule of ATP is written and here there is no net gain of ATP. So, this is also ruled out. Now, focus on the option number 1, where it says one molecule of pyruvic acid, correct. Two molecules of ATP, correct. One molecule of NADH2, yes. Here, you can see this is one molecule of NADH2. So, this is also correct. So, the correct option for the given question is option number 1, which says, from glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, you will get one molecule of pyruvic acid, two molecules of ATP and one molecule of NADH2. Let's pick up the next question. Question number 95. Select the incorrect statement with respect to alcoholic fermentation in yeast. Alcoholic fermentation in yeast produces alcohol. Now, first option says pyruvic acid is converted into alcohol. True. CO2 is evolved. True, because pyruvic acid, it is a 3-carbon molecule. Alcohol, it is a 2-carbon molecule because it is ethyl alcohol. So, 1 carbon is released in the form of CO2. Now, third option, magnesium ion is required during decarboxylation of pyruvic acid. Yes, because magnesium acts as a cofactor for the enzyme. Fourth one, pyruvic acid is completely oxidized into alcohol in the absence of oxygen. No doubt it is absence of oxygen, because it is fermentation, but pyruvic acid is not completely oxidized into alcohol. This is incomplete oxidation of pyruvic acid into alcohol. If it would have been complete oxidation, then there should not be alcohol formation. There should be only CO2 plus H2O formation. So the correct option for the given question is option number 4. Let's move to the next question.